Hey, good morning, everybody. This is Alan with Max, and I got all my bags packed, and you know, really wish I could take everything, all my family with me, and good old Maxter here, but I really don't think he'd get along too well with the yak, so we're going to go ahead and let him go. All right, Max, off he goes. So let me tell you a little bit about this climb. Obviously, this is climb number 3 in the 7 Summits Climb for Alzheimer's Memories Everything. Summited Vinson back in December, and Aconcagua in January. Had a couple of months here, about 6 weeks since Aconcagua. Continued the training, preparation, and it's time to climb. So let me tell you a little bit about the Everest climb. I'll be climbing with International Mountain Guides, as most people know by now. I'll be climbing on their classic team, which means that I'll be climbing with a Sherpa. And so what we're going to do is, first off, I'm leaving this afternoon. I'm going to go to Bangkok and then on to Kathmandu. Spent a day or two there meeting up with the rest of the team, and then we're going to fly to Lukla, the little airstrip, about 9,400 feet. And then we're going to take about 10 days to trek up to base camp at 17,500 feet. And the reason we're going to take so long is that it's not that far. It's only about 30 miles, but we need to get our bodies acclimatized to the altitude. And so by taking our time, we're going to gently let our bodies create more red blood cells, which carry oxygen to our muscles, and that'll help us as we start to climb higher. Also, the Khumbu trek is just a fantastic part of the climb, as everybody that's read anything I've ever written about the Khumbu knows. It's one of my favorite parts of any Himalayan. So once we get to base camp, then we're going to actually backtrack just a little bit back down near Gorik Shep and climb nearby Lobache. Now, this is a 20,000 foot so-called trekking peak, and I love that term, trekking peak, for a 20,000 foot mountain, but in reality, it's not very technical, but the altitude is certainly challenging, and that'll be an opportunity again to further acclimatize and also to kind of get our mountain feet, because we're going to be climbing, there'll be some fixed ropes, there'll be crampons. It obviously can be extremely cold at 20,000 feet. This is full of snow, and so I've never chased, so it's going to be an interesting climb for me. Back to base camp, and then we'll begin the acclimatization process, going through the Khumbu Icefall, up through the Western Khum, up the Lhotse Face, and then back down to base camp. Now, we're going to go up and down, as everybody is familiar by now with the whole acclimatization process, and that's going to take around 3 weeks or so to go up and down several times, and that, again, is to get our bodies to be acclimatized. Back down to base camp, and at this point, it's really just kind of waiting for the weather window. Right now, the schedule, with everything being perfect, which it never is in climbing, would be that we would summit around May 17th. So we'll see how that goes, but coming back, the climb is going to be to go back up all the way to Camp 2, up to the South Col, and then that infamous 12 to 18 hour climb to try to get to the top of the world. So I'll be dispatching, writing posts the entire way. Sometimes it'll just be a voice dispatch. Other times it'll be a written dispatch. I hope to be able to upload some videos to bring everybody along in the process. And again, as everybody knows, this is all about helping to raise awareness for Alzheimer's and also to raise money to find a cure through research. You know, I've got some very startling facts here on this page that I hope you read, but it bears repeating over and over again that every 70 seconds, another family begins that tragic journey. And I say tragic because, you know, there is no cure for this disease, and the treatments treat the symptoms, you know, we need a lot more. And that's what the research is all about. So I'm really hoping that the people will sign up to pledge a penny a foot for every foot that I climb. So that's about $196 for Everest. And I calculate that by starting at Lukla at 9,400 feet, all the way to the summit at 29,035 feet. So that's where the roughly 19,000 feet come from that I'll be climbing. A penny a foot is $196. And it's over 2 months. So, you know, if you think about how much you spend on coffee, maybe it's a better investment over the next couple of months. Please, please follow along. I hope you enjoy the coverage. I'm going to do my best to kind of cover what's happening on the mountain, but, you know, it's kind of difficult to cover both sides and climb at the same time. So I think you'll understand, and hope you'll enjoy the overall coverage that I do. I think that's about it. So next climb after this one is to Denali. It's very, very quick. I'll get back around the end of May, 1st of June, then leave at the end of June for Denali. And so lots more about the highest mountain in North America once we get Everest under our belt. It is a difficult climb. I am well prepared. It's going to be an exciting climb. I'm going to absolutely do my best. And I hope you come along. But more importantly, I hope you do a little bit of research and through the links on the sites. Climb4AD.com, go to our Facebook page, which is just Climb4AD in Facebook, and of course on the blog here on AlanArnette.com. But most importantly, I hope that you make a donation to the Cure Alzheimer's Fund or to the National Family Caregivers Alliance in support of family caregivers, and they are the silent victims of Alzheimer's. Okay, everybody. I gotta go, gotta get to the airport, gotta catch my flight. All right, climb on. This is Alan, and remember, memories are everything.